You thought I was to die for. invite you to stand with us this moment. Thank God for that beautiful song. And thank Reverend Andre Adams, who led in a very popular song. And one is very meaningful. He just let us examine what he did and how he thought about us. Amen. And who else would think that much of us that they would certainly want to die for us? Amen. The Bible says, you know, it is rare if they would. But Jesus certainly did. And so thank God that we can say still to this day that he died for all of us. And so the Lord is good, and we commend our choir ministry today. Certainly for how they have sung, and musicians certainly have played. And so we thank God for just that part of the worship that has let us even examine and reflect upon these songs, because they were ministering to us, but they were singing unto the Lord. And so I'm glad all of us could somehow connect with the songs. All of them just had something to say. And that's what it ought to be about. Not just singing and singing, but singing with purpose. Whatever we do, we ought to do it all unto the Lord. Amen. So God bless you. Let us just bow. God, we thank you for how you have led us and what you have brought us to. We certainly pray that you will help us today. And as we stand, we certainly stand as your servant. We stand, O Lord, knowing that you are able, knowing that your spirit is willing. And so help us and use us now, that we will be able to deliver the word that you have given to us. And it will be a timely word even for this present moment. God, we thank you, we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Those that may have your Bibles, we want to invite you to look to the book of Hebrews, chapter 13. And we want to look at verses 5 and 6. Hebrews, the 13th chapter, verses 5 and 6. Those that may have it, we invite you to read with us. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as you have. For he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. So that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. Amen. And by way of a subject, we'd like to talk about his promise and our response. Amen. His promise and our response. Amen. Today we look at a somewhat, I guess to some of us, a familiar passage of scripture today, and it is certainly a passage that will give us some hope, give us some encouragement, and especially for these times that we are in the midst of. Because I have said along the way that even we who are of faith, we have found ourselves being troubled by what is going on in this present world. And so as a result of it, I do believe that the Lord, he always has something to say and something to give that will keep the righteous not, amen, giving up on him. Because I do believe there is a calculated attack that the enemy is certainly the instrument of, and trying to get we who are in Christ to lose hope, to give up on God, and believe that God is nowhere to be found. And so this passage that we have before us today is certainly one to give us some hope. And I don't know who in here find themselves losing a little hope, find themselves wondering if the Lord is doing what he promised that he will do. But this passage of scripture I am very impressed with, because part of verse 5 is actually something that was recorded and really said to Joshua. Amen. The promise of God never leaving nor forsaking. And when we look at this today, brothers and sisters, I do believe it is his promise to those of us who do believe. And I wonder today, are there some of us who are in this place today can say without a doubt that I believe in his promises? Because his promises have certainly been a blessing to your and my life. And anything that God has to say that is directed to us, I do believe we need to believe it. We need to trust it. And not only that, we need to learn to live by it. And when I look at this today, this writer, who is nameless because some want to suggest it's Paul, some say Apollos, but whoever the writer is, I can say this, that they knew God. Oh yes, they knew who Jesus is. And so they present to us, amen, by way of this text, that first of all, he says, let your conversation, which is your conduct, be without covetousness. And he tells us to be content with such things as ye have. And when we think about these words are really speaking to where some of us are. Because there are some, even in the body of Christ, who are being covenant. They find themselves wanting, lusting. And sometimes it's after things that are really unimportant. Because I don't know how you feel about that, which is of the world. That stuff is just stuff. And sometimes we find ourselves focused on it too much, that we find ourselves not realizing where all our help comes from. And I do suggest that this first part of this verse is really a statement, certainly to give us some direction. That don't let your, amen, focus be on how much you can gain. Because there are some in the body that want to be rich. And really, they don't know what they're asking for, nor desiring for, because of a false sense of what the world has presented to us, that this is the way life ought to be. But I got to let you understand, in this life, Jesus did remind us that we will still have the poor among us. Oh yes, and some of us may have been there, but God made sure we got out of that situation. Where we can be, like he says, content with such things as they are. And so we got to, at some point on this journey, just learn to be grateful for what we have. Amen. Because your blessing ain't in what you have. All what you have is temporal. And listen, if you don't believe this, it has an expiration. It has an expiration. It's not designed to outlive you. Because you know that even with clothes. Oh yes, they don't always, amen, fit the same. Amen, somebody. And the reason why is because something has happened. Yes. Time has brought about a change. And so therefore, don't get caught up in getting how much clothes you can get. Because after a while, that stuff is going to wear. Amen. And we have to understand that this writer is going somewhere. He wants us to take our focus on trying to figure out how much I can gather, how much I can gain. And he getting things in perspective by saying, you just know how to be satisfied with what you have. Anybody in here learning that? Let me just bring Paul in here in the fourth chapter of Philippians when he says about the state that he done found himself in. He learned how to be content. And what gets me there, he said he learned. Amen. And learning comes from experience. It ain't just something you're born with. You go through some things that you will learn from them. And so this writer is on the same line of thought with Paul. He tells us to be content with what you have. But here is the promise. And you know what? I could almost close it there. But I got to tell you about the response. But the promise is what he has said.
Yes.
Anybody know he?
Yes.
Who has said it?
Yes.
Amen. And this ain't one time where you can see where he is capitalized, but this is certainly the Lord that has said this. He says, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. I tell you, that's a good way to just shout and close it there. As they say, shut it down. But you got to understand that's a promise that the Lord has made. And anybody in here found out that God is true? Anybody find him leaving you? Nor forsaking you? I'd like to know who you are, because I think you need to re-examine. Amen. How you living and what God is doing in you. God has never left us nor forsaken us. And the only reason we got breath in us, we rose this morning, is because of the God I'm speaking of right now. He said, I will never leave thee. Never is what it says. He won't do it. He won't leave you nor forsake you. And it's good to know that's a promise that you can live by. That's a promise that you can rise every morning knowing that God is still with me. Everybody rose this morning knowing that God was with you. Amen. Don't you understand that it's because of him we live, we move, and have our being. I can do this because of him.
That's right.
Not because of is my body. It's only because God has put it in the body that I can do that. And just to see this, brothers and sisters, is good to know you can trust in his promises. Amen. I'm glad that he won't never leave nor forsake you. Now, somebody may not believe me today, but God wanted me to let you know this. I ain't forgot you. I know you're going through it. I know you in the midst. But I have not forgotten you. You don't realize that the reason you ain't lost your mind. Hallelujah. It's because I'm with you. I just believe that you know he's with you. You can certainly understand that he won't leave you nor forsake you. And so I just thought somebody who's here today in the midst of us who don't understand, God knows what you're going through. And if you just trust him long enough, you're going to see your salvation. You're going to see your witness, your deliverance. You're going to be able to know that God will make a way somehow. So my brothers and sisters, I'm glad he left a promise. Amen. And this is an old promise that he shared, as I said, with Joshua. And I do believe there's some more Joshuas who need to know that God won't leave you nor forsake you. And isn't it good to know that he won't do it? That he stands by what he says. But finally, brothers and sisters, here's our part to what the writer declares. Since he says, let your conversation be without covetousness, be content with what? Such things as ye have, for he, what, has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake you. But I love verse 6. Because I don't care what you say, this should be our response.
Yes.
So that we may boldly, look at how that verse follows verse 5. After we learn, I will never leave you. Same thing. So that we may boldly say.
Yes.
Now, y'all hear me, this is our response.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. And don't be fickle about it.
Come on,
man. Amen. Somebody ought to be bold.
Yes.
Be confident.
Yes.
Listen, have some assurance.
Yes.
That this is what you ought to say, that the Lord is my helper.
Yes.
And I will not fear what man yes. shall do unto me.
Yes.
Anybody here
yes.
know that the Lord
yes.
is
yes.
your helper?
Yes.
In fact, have you ever had to call on your helper
yes.
to come to your rescue?
Yes.
That's our response to his promise.
Yes.
I be them promise I won't leave you nor forsake you. My response ought to be to him is, well, Lord, then you're my helper.
Yes.
I don't have to fear what Trump is doing.
Amen.
Amen. But I realize where my help
yes.
comes from.
Yes.
Anybody hear me today?
Yes.
Listen, I understand why the Holy Ghost said go here because
yes.
somebody needs to be reminded of his promise.
Yes.
And that we ought to have a response.
Yes.
Aren't you glad that we ought to be able to boldly say the response?
Yes.
Proudly cry it out.
Yes.
Let the world know, and whoever don't believe you,
yes.
that the Lord is my helper.
Yes.
And I don't know about you, every now and then I need some help.
Yes.
From the Lord.
Yes.
I don't know about you, I can't do it always on my ability.
Yes.
I can't do it always on my little strength.
Yes.
But I know somebody who is greater
yes.
than me.
Yes.
Who I can boldly say is my helper.
Yes.
Have I got a witness?
Yes.
Somebody know today. From the Lord. Ain't you all right? And I'm just glad that the text will declare. There is some inclusiveness. Amen. When he says so that we may boldly say. Pilgrims, that's speaking to all of us. That we all ought to be able to declare with our mouths. That the Lord is my helper. Listen, that's some shouting news. Just to know that he is your help. Certainly in the time of trouble. I'm reminded in Psalm 46 that the Lord is my refuge and my strength. He's a very present help in trouble. Have I got a witness? Brothers and sisters, I thought you ought to know today. If the Lord has promised, you can respond to whatever he has promised. If he said he's your help, you ought to boldly declare, I know without a doubt, the Lord is my help. And I don't have to fear no one, not even the devil himself. But my God is more than that. Nor forsake us, but I respond to the matter of obedience. The Lord is my helper, and I don't have to fear what man shall do. Tell them they don't believe you. Tell them they want to persecute you. Tell them they're causing trouble for you. They don't know where my help comes from. Have I got a witness? Somebody today, I feel the right to say. We ought to boldly say,
my helper. You ought to get personal about your declaration of your God. I see why Paul had to declare to the Philippians after telling them in the fourth chapter, verse 13, so we can do all things through Christ. He was inclusive. When we drop down to verse 19, look at his change of words. He says, for my God, listen to what I'm saying. My God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I thought you ought to know. You ought to get personal. Sometimes with God, you ought to tell somebody, he's mine. Yes, he's mine. How do I know? I tried him for myself. I realized ain't nobody do me like the Lord. It'd be all right. I'm just convinced that about myself.
So when he says he won't leave you nor forsake you, what are you going to say? Is he your helper? That's what you ought to tell him. The Lord is okay with me. If you're there, I know I can make it. I know I can get through it. I know I can outlive it. I know I can survive it. Long as you're my helper, that the Lord wants us to believe what that word says.
Yes, Lord.
So brothers and sisters, when you feel you're alone, you ain't alone. Because he said he won't never leave. Never alone.
Yeah.
I love that old hymn when they talk about never alone. Because he promised never to leave us alone. And I'm glad that God is always there. Anybody know that he is?
Yes.
Now listen, when it seems like it's looking bad, then the Lord. Yes, somebody. Then the Lord. He'll change that situation. Then the Lord. He'll fix it for you. Then the Lord, he'll put a smile on your face. Then the Lord, he'll turn you around. Then the Lord, will place your feet on the solid ground. Then the Lord, will pick you up and let you stay. Then the Lord, will let everything be all right. God bless you today, saints. God bless you, and thank the Lord today. I'm going to leave you alone, but I'm just grateful to what the Lord has showed us today. You ain't got to worry about these times. You let God handle it. You just stay close to Him, and God will see you through. Oh, yes, it's troubling in our country, but this is when God is now looking good. Because more people are to be attracted to Him now. And know that God will take care of you. Because He know how to make a promise on your life. And He will hold Himself to it. So anybody here today that's troubled, God wants you to know He ain't left you. He ain't forsaken you. But He wants you to know this. He's your helper. And wants you to boldly declare with your mouth, the Lord is my helper. Say it with me today. The Lord is my helper. One more time. The Lord is my helper. God bless you today. God bless you. At this time, brother, let's go forth with the invitation.